Hello friends, I am Dhiraj Kumar from my YouTube channel 9 Exceptions, and today we are going to learn about the Docker image, Docker container, how to run image file, what is container ID and all that. So before going to start, in the last video we learn about what is Docker, why Docker and the installation steps. So if you are new to Docker, so this is my suggestion. So first go through my previous video, then come to this video. I have provided the link in the description part. You can go and see the last video. So let's start with the Docker image. So what is Docker image? A image is nothing. It's having the information of your application. Like what commands we need to provide at the time of running the application, and what all dependencies we need to provide at the time of running the applications, what are the internal commands, what are the external commands. So all these present inside the image. So if you see, I have here a Docker account. And if you go to Explorer tab, just click on Explore. Okay, I'm already in the Explorer tab. And this all are the images. This all are the images like MySQL, Oracle, and Alpine, BusyBox, Redis, Postgres. And so all these are the image file. This is the inbuilt image file. We can say it's a library, like we have some Java library, some Python library. So that Docker also provided us some inbuilt images so that we can use that image and we can learn about the Docker. And after that, we can create our own custom images. So these are the predefined images. So today I will use the Hello World image and I will show you how an image is built and how we can create a container. Right, so this is the all about Docker image. Now what is Docker container? A container is nothing, it's an instance of the image that is called container. So when we run any image, on that time a container is created. So that container is called and the an instance of the image. Right, now the third is how to run image file. So let's come to the command prompt. And the command to run any image file is docker run then the image file name. So here we are going to use the inbuilt image file, right? So we have all these are the image files. So currently I am going to run the hello world image file. So just provide the name of the image, hello world, and hit enter. So you can see here I got the message from the Docker, hello from Docker, this image shows that your installation appears to be working directly, and all the steps here provided. So all these steps I will give you an overview or step by step information about all these steps in my next video. So the current aim of this topic is what is Docker image, container, and how to run an image, and what is container ID, right? So here and now, if you want to see whether my image is running or not, or what is the container ID, so all this information you will get if you type docker ps hyphen hyphen all. It will provide all the container which is currently running. Hit enter and see. This is my container ID. The ID is generated. My image file is hello world. And my command, my URL is slash hello. When I ran this one a minute ago, current the status is exit. And the port is nothing because I haven't provided any port. And this is the Docker inbuilt name. So, as you know, I ran hello world image with docker run command. So if you want to run any image, you have to use docker run command. I will provide another video about the docker commands, all the basic commands and advanced commands. All these commands I will provide a video in the next session. So for now, just a reminder, this is my container ID. A container ID is created, and this is my image file, and this is the URL. So what ps-all does, it will provide all the container which is currently running in your terminal. So this is all about the docker image, docker container, and how to run an image file. And if you want to run some more images, you can run, like suppose these all are the images, right? So let me run one more image. Let's suppose I want to run busybox. So go to terminal and provide the command docker run and busybox and hit enter. Now check whether it's running or not. Docker ps-all. You can see here another container ID is created, and which image file we ran? We ran busybox image file, right? So this is the all about the docker image, docker container, and how to run a image file, and how the container ID is created. In the next video, we are going to learn about docker commands and docker custom images. So here we saw the example of inbuilt images. Now in the next videos, we will create our own image and we will run that image and create a container. Thank you.